Crystal. I've loved dolls my whole life. I collect everything from porcelain to cloth, American Girl, neonates, and real care dolls. But my favorite is to collect and make reborn dolls. There's Chloe, Grace, Jeremy, Maya, Yuki, Savannah, Zoe, Haley, Landon, and Maisie. It isn't easy keeping up with my collection, but it sure is a lot of fun. Hi guys. So I'm here to change Landon out of his pajamas that he's had on for a few months now. Now, before I start to change him, I just wanted to mention really quick, if you remember a few videos back, I was talking about how 2018 so far hasn't been so great between the school shooting, and I was talking about some things that have happened to my friends, how some of them have lost their parents, some of their parents are going through health struggles, a friend of mine was diagnosed with cancer, things like that. And I also had mentioned there was a girl who was in the American Girl Instagram community. And her name was Bella. And since I made that video, she celebrated her 15th birthday. And she had a big party at American Girl. And then on, I believe it was Friday. Friday on my way home from work, I was on Instagram and I found out that she passed away. She had been fighting cancer for the last 2 years, probably almost 3 years at this point. And I think when I had made my video, I told you guys that it wasn't looking good. Like, she had posted that she had a whole bunch of new tumors that were discovered, and the doctors pretty much said there was nothing else they could do for her, and she had been put onto hospice care. But she was still so strong and fighting, and she was praying for a miracle, and all of us were. And 2 days before she passed away, she had posted on Instagram that she was resting up, that she was going to be going to see this certain doctor in this, I forget which city it was, but she was going to go see this doctor who thought that she might be eligible for a clinical trial drug. And so she was really hopeful about that, but she was recuperating because she had been having some issues with her lungs, because there was tumors in her lungs, and she had been having issues with them causing, I think it was blood clots and things like that. So anyways, this doctor was away last week, but would have been back this week, and she was going to see him this week, but she didn't make it. So the whole American Girl Instagram community is very sad. It's very sad to see someone so young go through so much and pass away. It brings back a lot of feelings and memories of when my cousin Brittany passed away, because my cousin Brittany passed away in April as well. In a couple of weeks, it's going to be the anniversary of her death. And she passed away when she was 16 and a half. So very close in age to Bella. And so hearing of Bella's death just really brings back everything. Like, it's something I will never forget when I lost my cousin, because we were like sisters and I loved her so much and our whole family did. She was just so inspiring, so beautiful, so full of life, and her dancing was, she was a dancer, she was beautiful, and I found out that Bella actually was a dancer before her cancer diagnosis, and then she had to have a tumor removed from her, I think it was her knee or somewhere in her leg, and she wasn't able to dance anymore after that. But to know that she was also a dancer, it just brings it all home, like the connection. And I just know exactly what the family is going through, because we had lost members of our family before Brittany, but they were all elderly people, you know, in their 80s and 90s. And so, you know, when people get to that age, that death is inevitable. You know, everyone dies at some point in life. And while it's sad to lose them, you know that they've had a full life. I mean, you know, into their 80s and 90s, that's incredible. And so you just kind of, it's just expected. And so even though it's hard and it's sad when they pass, it's a little easier, I think, to accept and deal with, because you know that it's just part of life. You know what I mean? But when it's a child, it's like, it's not the, in the same, I don't know how to explain it. It's just not the same. It's just, it's horrible. It's not the order of things for children to die. And it is just something you never forget. It gets easier as time goes on, but that hurt and that loss never goes away, because you can't help but think about how much life she had ahead of her and what she may be doing or accomplishing. And it's just hard. It's just been a hard situation for me, because it brings that all up. And I followed Bella on Instagram for, I think, the last year. And she was so beautiful and so inspiring. I loved seeing her photos of her American Girl dolls. She had a knack for photography. I envied her photography. I wish I knew how to take pictures like that of my dolls. And any posts that she made regarding her health journey were so uplifting, so inspiring. Despite everything that she was going through, she always stayed positive. She always had a smile in every one of her pictures, the biggest, brightest smile that lit up my day every time I saw her pictures. And she gave me strength to deal with my own health. And so it's just been a great loss for the community. So please keep her friends and family in your prayers. And so anyways, I just wanted to mention that first and foremost. But now let's get Landon changed. And I also have something that I'm gonna talk about. Okay, so I've had a few times where I have been asked why I don't make reborns for myself. Why do I get custom reborns made, or I buy already made reborns? If I'm a reborn artist, why don't I just make them for myself to save money? So there's a few reasons, but the very main reason is that I'm a collector. I'm a doll collector. as you can see, I have all kinds of dolls in my collection. Not just reborn dolls. I have, you know, my cloth-bodied dolls from an Etsy store, from an artist that makes those. I have some of my childhood dolls still. I have American Girl dolls. I have a couple of mini one-of-a-kind resin dolls. I have all kinds of dolls, really. And so I just love dolls and I like to collect. And so because of that, I like to, when it comes to reborn dolls, I like to have different artists in my collection. I have certain artists that I love their work and I just enjoy having different artists' work in my collection. It's as simple as that. That's the simplest answer I can give you guys, is that I enjoy that. On top of that, I will say there was a point in time where I had bought some reborn doll kits with the intentions of reborning them for myself. I had the Kylan kit by Laura Tuzio Ross that I had originally bought to reborn for myself. And I had bought the Robin kit by Adri Stowett to make for myself because I was going to make her to look like this little girl that I really loved, that was in one of the daycares I worked at. So there, she was another one. But I'm in the process, I'm trying to sell that kit now. And I sold the Kylan kit, and I've just been clearing out the old kits I have in my stash because honestly, it's been so long since I bought them, and there's other kits I would be more interested in reborning than those kits. Plain and simple. I'm just not interested in reborning those anymore. And I think that was one of the things that was affecting my drive to reborn. I have not really, other than painting the Lupus kit here and there, which I'm actually finally finished that doll. I just have to seal the head one last time and then put the doll together and finally be finished. So that is going to be up for a charity auction on eBay in May for Lupus Awareness Month. And I will let you guys know about that when it's up. But anyways, I haven't really reborned in 2 whole years, maybe even a little bit longer. And that's just because, A, I think I was just not really, I kind of burned myself out because I was doing so many custom orders. And so when I was doing custom orders, I had no time at all to reborn for myself. I just didn't have time because I was working on the customs. So I just didn't have the time to reborn for me. Then I just got burned out from doing so many customs that I just wanted a break from it. So after I finished my last custom, I just decided to take a break. Well, then I started to have a lot of problems with my health. The last 2 years have been really rough when it comes to my health. I've just been sick from my lupus, but also just like because my immune system is so low from the medications I take, I've been sick with like stomach bugs, flus, colds, like it's just one thing after another, guys. It's like I get rid of one thing and something else pops up, and it's been a rough 2 years. And so when I'm not feeling well, I don't feel like reborning at all. And especially if my joints are bothering me, in my hands, to paint with my paintbrushes, and rooting is even worse. Rooting is so bad when my hands hurt. So I just took a break. I just decided, you know what, I'm gonna take a break, and when that urge hits me again to start reborning, that's when I'll do it. Because if my heart's not into it, guys, then it's, you know, my work is not gonna turn out as good, is the way I looked at it, and I want my work to be good. So I needed that break, and I'm glad I took it, and I'm hoping now this year I can get back into it. But then when I started looking through my kits to reborn, I'm like, these are such old kits. I am not interested in reborning these kits at all anymore. Even the ones that I had bought to reborn for myself, I'm like, I don't want this one anymore in my collection. So I've just been working on selling off all of those kits to get a fresh start. So once I've sold all those kits and everything, I think I only have 2 kits left to sell. Once I sell those, then I am going to buy a new recent sculpt that, you know, I'm really interested in painting, and that should get me going. Although I still have Cyan that I'm in the middle of painting, so I have to finish that one first. And I do want to finish her because I do really like that sculpt. So yeah, so I just didn't have any desire to do any for myself, nor did I have the time. And like I said, there's lots of artists that I just love their work. There's just something that speaks to me from their work, which to me is like any artwork, whether it be artwork you hang on your wall, whatever, you know, like even if you can paint your own pictures, there might be certain artists that you admire and you want to own their work. It's the same thing with the reborns. So that's just the way it goes. And then now I still have my first reborn I made, and her name is Chloe. I don't handle her much and that's why you don't see her in videos much, because she's the first I made, I want to try to keep her in the best condition possible. So I don't like to handle her very much. So that's her. And then of course Grace I made. I did make Grace for myself, and I've kept her. And at one point I also had Buggy by Bonnie Brown, who I had named Shiloh, and I had made her, just, you know, I originally, I think, had made her with the intention of selling her, but I fell in love with her and I decided to keep her. Well, eventually I decided I only wanted one sleeping baby and fell in love with my Serenity, who I named Haley. And in order to get her, I had to sell the sleeping babies I currently had. So I sold my Buggy Brown, and she resides with my dear friend Angela, who loves her to bits. So I'm really happy that she has her. And I think that's it. I don't know if I owned any others that I made. I think those were the only 3. And so now I have the 2. And who knows, you know, maybe at some point I will feel like making another reborn for myself. I don't know. Whoops, sorry, Lynn. I really don't know. It just depends on how I feel and if I have the time and the energy. So we'll see. But really and truly, I just, as a collector, I just love to have other people's work in my collection. You know, like Kate Charles is an artist that I really admire, and I'm so blessed and thankful to own two babies that were custom made for me by her. Landon, of course, I love Susan's work. She did Landon and Yuki, and I'm so thankful to have them. You know, I love Maisie. Her artist is amazing, Amanda, so I'm so grateful to be able to own one of her works. And Joshua was by Michelle Kite, who I love her too. I love her, all her work. So I've got lots of dream babies. Savannah and Haley are by Sheila Ron, who's another incredible artist. I love her work. So it's just nice to be able to have some of my favorite artists, their work in my home. It's cool. I like it. So that's that topic I just wanted to discuss, because I know I've had a few people ask over the years, and I've been meaning to make this video for quite a while now, but finally got around to it. So here's Mr. Landon. I decided to dress him up a little. This is what I wanted him to wear on his birthday on Saturday. It's a onesie, but it's like a dressy shirt onesie. That's a yellow, turquoise, white, and navy blue stripes. It's from Gymboree, and our good friend Angela sent it to us. Yes, the same Angela that owns my Buggy Brown. And I paired it with some jeans and just some little socks to keep his feet warm. So he looks absolutely adorable. And yeah, this was going to be his, either his birthday outfit on Saturday, or then I was thinking of doing Sunday best, but just didn't get around to doing it. There was a lot to do on Saturday. And then I was out all day Sunday, so. Anyways, guys, I hope you enjoyed seeing Landon, and I'm glad that he's finally changed into a new outfit. He looks absolutely handsome. My handsome little guy. I still gotta figure out, I gotta get his lips fixed, though. But I think what I wanna do is take him outside into some natural light to really get a good look at things, because I'm wondering if his skin tone is fading a bit too. His lips are looking bluish, and I don't know, I feel like maybe his skin tone is fading a little bit, but I would have to take him into natural light to see. I just feel like when I look back at photos of him when I first got him, that his skin tone was a little more vibrant, that his blushing was a little more pinky, and he had a real good peaches and cream complexion. And I feel like it might be fading, but again, it could be the lighting. We live in a basement, and we do have daylight light bulbs, but sometimes they're still not 100% accurate. So I feel like if I take him outside, maybe I can get a better idea of things, and then I can kind of figure out where I want to go from there in terms of fixing him up. I don't know if his artist, if I would maybe contact her, and maybe she can touch him up like she did with Yuki. Or if maybe I could just go and use Marilyn's air dry paints to kind of touch him up. I haven't decided yet, but I still love him. He still looks adorable. I love his big eyes, his big blue eyes, and his hair. But as you know, with all reborns, when you get a new baby, you just tend to focus on that baby. I mean, if you guys remember when I got Landon, I practically for an entire year focused on only him. You hardly saw any of my other babies, and so right now Joshua is the same way for me. I love him so much, and I mean, everything about him is perfect. His skin tone is incredible. I love his painted hair. It doesn't get messed up. And whenever I take him out, they all think he's real. Most people don't even question it. So that's lots of fun. But anyways, I'm going to wrap up this video. I hope you enjoyed my little chat. Thanks so much for watching, guys. And we'll see you next time. Bye!